Hello champions, I'm at Verd, the red player. In this game, let's see which continent should I go for. I see I've got a bunch of troops spawned in this area. I could potentially go for Southern Europe with plus 4 troop bonus. I could also go for Central Europe with 5 plus troop bonus. And also Red Hessen France, aka Western Europe is made of 1 troop territories as well. I could consider going for this continent as well. Right here the white player drastically expands into the Russian Empire, aka with plus 7 troop bonus, which is basically 2 continents at once. Good for the white player for sure, guys. Let's send him an alliance request, and at the same time let's send an alliance request to the rest of the players as well. The white player has accepted my alliance request. Let's send him a thumbs up, and at the same time for the green player as well. The green player makes a smart choice by going for the Narek Alps. The Narek Alps is a very easy continent to capture, so he will start gaining plus 4 troops immediately, so assuming nobody ends up breaking through him. And then when it comes to me, guys, I would be tempted going for Western Europe, but the thing is that the black player doesn't accept my alliance request, guys. He might end up going for Southwestern Europe. What if at least a blue player accepts my alliance request? Well, oh well, guys, I think I will still just going for this continent and we'll see how it goes, guys. Let's stick over it and let's fortify my 2 troop army from Denmark to another border here. As long as the black player doesn't break for us, guys, we should be good. But here is the biggest question, guys, whether he breaks for us or not, and no, he adds more troops. The Portugal takes over Galicia, guys, and it will be one more turn before he finally takes over Southwestern Europe to get plus 4 troops. Myself, I will probably expand to Southern Europe, because I assume the blue player will go for Iceland. Plus, we'll probably like to expand into the British Empire as well, guys. The purple player gets a super bad blitz, attacking with his Ankara army to Istanbul. And I'm not sure why does he go for Orient at the first place, guys. Because even if he successfully managed to capture that split part in Istanbul, he would have also have to get the Georgian territory, which is cut off as well, guys. And he doesn't even have any troops in the Russian Empire next to it, guys. So that's a terrible continent choice for the purple player for sure, guys, but let's see if he makes a comeback. The blue player, no, after all, doesn't go for Iceland, he decides to go for Scandinavia. Interesting. And will you win that 5 versus 2 blitz? This is a relatively high blitz. I believe 93% chance. And please invade green, that would be appreciated. Yes, let's go. With that attack, basically, I'm the only player who has a continent, guys. So that is something what I really like for sure, guys. The question is whether I should expand into the British Empire, guys, or should I expand into Southern Europe now? The thing when it comes to Southern Europe is what I will always be able to get it later, guys. But in case if I do not expand into the British Empire, there's a high possibility that the blue player decides to go for this continent. So for that reason, I'm really tempted expanding into the British Empire first, guys. Right here, the green player takes over this continent, guys, and might probably be good. Alright, so let's add more troops to this territory over here, guys. I might even take over Iceland, honestly. Alright, well, let's attack that green player's territory over here, guys. Let's go. Alright, well, let's go into Iceland, guys. Let's take over the smaller continent first. I will let the blue player to move out his 2 troop army from Gotland over here if he wants. And myself, let's set that troop army over here like that, guys. Even for the black player didn't accept our alliance request, so far he is being a good neighbor. He doesn't threaten us, he doesn't look forward to break for us, guys. For I have to be prepared for anything, guys, because once he receives a troop bonus, he could definitely break through Gascony and shrink his borders to 2 instead of 3. Surprisingly, the purple player still tries taking over Istanbul, guys. He doesn't realize that Georgia right here is a cut off territory, guys. So right here he must be very confused, guys. The biggest question, guys, is what do I do about black? Do I attack him or not? In case I trust him, in case he doesn't end up attacking me, guys, then it would be better to be friends. I would rather expand into another continent. Otherwise, if I knew that the black player would be hostile, then it would obviously be better for me to betray him first. The blue player breaks through the Russian Empire, good for us, guys. The blue player is actually being a world police, wow. Instead of trying to take over a continent for himself, he tries breaking through other player's continents, guys. So in this case, I'm really happy to be allied with a world police player, guys, because that player is literally doing the dirty work for me. If I was a blue player, I would have just simply taken over Finland and start receiving plus 3 troops. The green player could consider expanding to Southeastern Europe, the plus 4 troop continent, for if he wants to be safe, and yes, he should properly guard all of those three borders. And then in next turn, he can execute that plan as well, guys. Plus 10 troops received by me, guys, and do I play aggressively or do I just simply take over the British Empire and that's it? I think it might be better if I neutralize a black player, guys, honestly. Because a blue player is being a really annoying player to green and white. Here, let's add more troops over here, guys, and yes. Yes, I think I must attack a black player over here, guys. I do not want to risk that, the black player potentially breaking through me, guys. So let's neutralize him first by ourselves. Let's go. Let's take over those additional territories over here, guys. Let's not forget taking over the British Empire as well, guys, and let's fortify my... Well, I actually have to fortify my fortress army over here, guys. I thought I can't guard against a black player right here, guys, but a black player could add troops to Portugal and still break through over here. And so, okay, will you make it? Yes! Bad blitz, black. That is huge for us, guys. That is huge, the black player loses the game, and right here we are guaranteed being in a strong position, so as long as other players do not break for us, guys. The purple player thinks his Egyptian army, if he wants to get a continent, he should definitely consider expanding into either North Africa or Southeastern Europe. Alright, he makes this attack as well, guys, and 3 versus 1, he makes it as well. If he successfully holds it, he will be receiving plus 3 troops. Why does he continue making those 2 versus 1 attacks, guys? That is just simply wasteful troops. Let's see if the blue player is actually fine with me holding all of those 3 continents, guys. Yes, please attack white, yes. The best case scenario for I do not understand why you rather didn't add all of your troops to Stockholm and then broke with Finland army. But in this case it works out as well. Please do that 3 versus 1. Let's go. And yes, I'm in a super good position and he wins even 4 versus 3, guys. That was supposed to be an unfavorable blitz, but in this case I'm really happy what he makes it, guys, because he's doing all the dirty work for us. He takes our alliance very seriously. Let's send him a thumbs up, guys. The green player right here switches his attention towards attacking, taking over this continent and attacking purple, guys. Wow, those players are making a lot of enemies to each other. The white player wants me to attack blue, but no, I'm not going to attack blue. What I would like to do is to attack black. Ideally, I want to eliminate the black player from the game. Let's add more troops over here, guys. At the very least, I want to wipe out the black player from over here, guys, but I think I will just eliminate him from the game like that. Hopefully, I get good blitz. Yes, it is a good blitz, guys. And yes, here we go. The black player gets the last available place. He takes the 6th place right here. I will rather trade in 3 soldiers because I want to get plus 2 troops in London, which is a border territory over here for the British Empire, guys. Let's just simply capture 1 troop territory over here, guys. And yes, let's go. And right here I'm fortifying that 4 troop army over here, guys, because right here those players definitely shouldn't let me hold so many continents. The purple player trades in a set at 3 cards, which is very huge for us, because he will look forward to retaliate to the green player, guys. Basically, the green player won't have a lot of troops to attack us. Well, let's see if the purple player actually breaks for green player, guys. And yes, yes, well, let's go. That is going to be an easy W, guys, for us. 6 troops received by blue. Let's see whether he considers breaking for us or not. And it looks like no, he adds most of his troops to Ruskiala. Attacks white, let's go. Yes, finish him off, blue. You will have to wait for some more, but basically you should get him. The white player is used for troops. Will he consider trading in assets? No, he might not have one, guys. K3 versus 2, he should use small rolls, but ideally he should rather skip his turn, guys. On the other hand, he wants to break through the Scandinavia, guys, so might be still good. Let's see what does the green player do. Please retaliate to the purple player. He also trades in a nature set. Please give me that W, green. Let's go. I mean, so let's see how much damage the purple player will take. And I mean, I could consider eliminating a purple player from the game, but the thing is that he's just at 1 card, guys. It wouldn't be worth for me to eliminate him at all. I could either attack green because the green player is the 2nd strongest player, or I could just simply take over Southern Europe over here, guys, and be good. Just let those players fight it out with each other. While myself, I will be taking over those continents, guys. Let's go. Let's attack at blue player's territory. Let's continue attacking territories over here as well, guys. Right, let's use that army over here. Let's make 1 more attack if it, let's go. Let's attack those purple player territories and basically make... Well, honestly, I could even eliminate a purple player from game over here, guys. How many troops would I receive right here by trading in a set? 10 troops, guys. Yeah, honestly, let's do it, guys. Let's not prolong the game. Let's attack those purple player territories over here, even if it isn't worth it, guys, but oh well. Let's eliminate a purple player from game. 10 troops received by me, guys. Let's trade in a set. And right here, what I have to do, guys, is to betray Green. Well, do I want to see as a good ally, guys? Let's see, I will actually see, guys, what the green player does. I will let him break through me if he wants. But on overall, let's see whether he honors alliance with us, guys, or not. Not much I can do over here, guys. Yeah, this players will have to decide, guys, which place do we will we take each, but at this point, how many troops the white player will receive? 12 troops. Could he eliminate blue? Well, it would be hard. 12 troops. I mean, he can try. Alright, let's see if he uses one troop, man roll, or just simply blitzes. He decides to blitz it, and I think he will feed the blue player for green, guys. Alright, so will you stop? But right here, interesting, guys, to let the green player hold continents for a psychological experiment. To see what would he do about that, guys. Would he play for the second place, or would he try breaking through me? Right here, he will play the white player. Says Victor, right here, the green player should go through me in order to eliminate blue. Because right here, the blue player has even 5 cards, guys. Let's see, right, start with Oslo to not end up splitting your troops. Unfortunately for you, that's a terrible blitz. And okay, that's a low percent chance, you should do man rolls. You should do man rolls. Okay, but he blitzes and still wins it, guys. Wow, wow. He actually ends up eliminating blue from the game. Let's see whether he attacks white, or will he just simply skip his turn? No, he is going to attack me, guys. Alright, fair enough, guys. Let's see how many continents will he break through, guys. He can definitely break through Brittany, through France right here, guys. But will he manage to break through one more of my continents as well here is question. And no, he stops. Here I have a set, guys. Let's read it in and which player should I eliminate from the game, guys. Let's try going for the green player first, guys, I assume, right? Let's add more troops over here, guys. Let's add more troops over here as well. The green player has betrayed us. So I'm eliminating the green player first, and I will give a second place to the white player at this point, guys. Let's see if we make it over here. Right, let's go over here as well, guys. Let's make a troop split. We should hurry because right here we're really running out of time. Right here, and let's switch to that blitz over here. Yes, we make it on time. The green player has been eliminated from the game, and wow, right here I get to trade in another set, guys. Good game, the white player says. Good game. I'll send you a heart, and let's attack our territory. White. Let's go. Let's see if we win blitz over here. Okay, this way we do not have to make a 3 troop split, guys. And can we make it in time, guys? The timer is really running out. And GG's. Wow. What a nice and sweet victory for us, guys, at the end.